Let's go, I'm ready. Yeah, right there with you. I'm here. Let me know when you guys need help. What? I don't need your help. Oh, really? You can do this by yourself. We'll see. I'm done. That's all I got. I got you, don't worry. I got this, guys. If we work together, we could be stronger. Let's do this, guys. Let's do this together. Yeah, that's right. Let's do this together.
And this is to go even further beyond.
Ah. What's up, guys? Coach Leo here. And in this video, I'm going to talk to you guys about the different energy systems we use on a daily activity that you didn't know. So there are three energy systems that you use on a daily basis, from going for a run, swimming, playing basketball, sprinting. They all work together, but some play a more important part than others depending on the type of activity that you're doing. Now, before I go into detail about the different energy systems, if you have questions about anything that I've mentioned in this video today, you can reach me at any of the socials down below, or you can hit the link at the very bottom to schedule a free consultation with me if you need more help with your program or anything else like that. And don't forget, hit like, subscribe, and that notification bell so you know when I posted that next video. So our body works off of three main energy systems. One that's immediate, that works initially when you get going, and it only lasts for a short amount of time. The second energy system works for longer, about a little bit longer, and it helps with relatively explosive movements, but not as explosive as the first one. And then your last one is an energy system that allows you to last longer durations of time and helps you maintain your pace, but obviously is not as explosive as the first or even the second one. The phosphagen system uses creatine phosphate and produces ATP at a rapid rate, and it helps you with immediate actions like sprinting or jumping out of the way or anything that's really explosive in the moment. The phosphagen system uses creatine phosphate and it's able to produce ATP at a rapid rate. It's great for rapid movements. So imagine Usain Bolt sprinting down the 100 meter track, right? His primary energy system that he's using is the phosphagen system because he's within 10 seconds, he runs 9 seconds, doesn't need the full 30, but he's using that energy system just for that race, and that's it. So the downside to this energy system, as much as we'd like to be able to just use it, use that one, and that's it, it uses creatine phosphate and ATP, and there's limited amounts of that available, readily available, so it only allows us to use for that 1 to 30 second bout. That's why it's great for explosive movements, but for a shorter period of time. The next system we're going to talk about is the anaerobic glycolysis system, also known as the lactic acid system. It doesn't require oxygen and uses energy contained within glucose to form ATP. It can work as an intermediate between the phosphagen system and the anaerobic system. Now, this energy system too can produce ATP quite quickly, and it really helps for those activities that help you push for longer than 30 seconds. So if you got past those first 30 seconds and you're still pushing and you still need a little bit more burst, this is where this energy system kicks into place. So think 200 meter swim. You know, the first 30 seconds you're able to push as hard as you can, but you need to be able to sustain that. And with this energy system, it allows you to recover slightly, but still keep a higher pace. Now the oxidative system, our last system we're gonna talk about, also known as the aerobic glycolysis, requires oxygen to produce ATP. And this is done in the mitochondria. So the mitochondria is within the cell. And using that, it allows you to last much longer bouts, longer durations of activity. So like running a marathon or going for a really long bike ride. The downside to this energy system is that ATP is produced very slowly. But if this energy system is trained efficiently and properly, it can help you maintain a steady pace for longer bouts. All right, so now you know about the three energy systems, and you gotta understand that the main goal of these energy systems is to be efficient and produce enough ATP for the muscles to contract. Some perfect examples of athletes using this to their optimum is LeBron James and Cristiano Ronaldo. Both the top tier of athletes where they're explosive when they need to be, but sustain a steady pace throughout the game. And even at times where they need to be explosive repeats, where they have to react to getting to the ball or make an adjustment on defense, they're able to do that because they've trained all three energy systems properly for their sport and their activity. Now, when it comes to an activity or sport that you're trying to prepare yourself for, it's real important to understand the energy systems and know which one you should be focusing on to really get you to that next level or push you to be able to be on par where you need to be. So if you're a football player that plays running back, I would not want you to be running for miles on miles and miles. The only thing that's gonna help you is, yes, you're gonna help your oxidative system and be able to develop those slow twitch fibers to help you last longer, but you're gonna lose any explosive movement because you're trading that off to have a bigger gas tank. Goal should be focused on being explosive while allowing there to be time and effort to train the oxidative system. So the focus should be more so on the first two energy systems. Not to exclude the oxidative system. There's definitely room and time to include that. However, a majority of that athlete's training should be heavily focused on sprints and explosive movements with tempo runs included to help with the oxidative system. Now, if you're a marathon runner, you do benefit from doing sprints, but I'm not gonna have you do sprints the whole time and never go running for more than 5 miles at a time. You need the mileage, you need that conditioning to be able to run the full 26 miles. So doing nothing but sprints alone is not gonna help you get better at a mile or let alone a marathon. So it's important to understand which energy system you should be focusing on depending on the activity. So there you have it, guys. Those are the three energy systems that help you through your activities. If you feel like you need help or need more guidance, you could definitely schedule a free phone consultation with me. Link in the description down below. Make sure you guys hit like, subscribe, hit that notification bell so you know when I posted that next video. All right, guys, make sure you guys are living a stronger life. Let's go.